Kibera Celtic Football Club was founded in 2007 and is currently based in the sprawling slums of Kibera in Langata constituency. The club was formed on the basis of uniting youth in the community following the post-election violence that had rocked the country. The team has connected together players from all Kenyan tribes with a mission of creating peace awareness to Kibera community through football. The team has featured in the Super League and Division 2 leagues before attaining promotion to the Nationwide League for the first time this season. The club has the ambition of developing talents from Kibera society and become world-class players.
We have got all different tribes in the team, and it has bring unity within the Kibera. But not only in Kibera alone, it is entire Kenya, because the league that we are playing now, we are in Division 1. And Division 1, it does not mean for the people of Kibera only. It's Kenya's at large.
Not to look only in football, but try to build a bigger thing, because this is a thing for the society. And you are doing things most probably in the slum. So that's where you can build your own youth academy and try to maybe teach life skills with the kids. It's like an avenue of selling your own ideas.
These are people who have passion for football. So it feels good to belong to a group where everybody likes what he's doing. And yet, since football is a passion, we make a passion out of our career, and that's the best place to be.
Us, who we live in the ghetto, we eradicate that idleness and come for training. And it's a big task for the management to win the hearts of the people living in the ghettos.
Like any other football club in the country, Kibera Celtic Football Club has been faced with a lot of challenges, which include a poor playing ground and inadequate finances that would make both ends meet.
We fight until we connect this team with the Celtic in Glasgow, and we were in a process of getting that brotherhood. And it's just a promise that they are coming on the way. So we had two friends from Scotland that has been helping us every and again. And now they have calculated the budget, and now the budget is a bit big for them. And now they were just living for the people of Kenya to come in.
Right now Kibera Celtic is in the Nationwide. They don't have a backup of maybe a youth structure. There isn't. And you know, to become a professional club, you need also money. So, and this is where we need cooperatives to help us.
They are supporting these things because they make their youth out of danger. As in, like football in Kibera Celtic is a danger-free zone. Because one, you relate to social life.
The only pitch that we are using is Woodley Green Stadium. And that stadium is very, very bad. It forces us to use it because when we go to hire the pitch, it is very expensive to us, because you are playing in home and you have to go and hire the pitch. When you go to Waldo, I will pay like 8,000. 8,000, I'll pay extra 4,000 for transportation of the boys. So when you calculate it, you will get 12,000 Kenya shillings. And when they improved that standard of Woodley ground, the 12,000 that I will pay for the pitch, I'll save and give the boys. So this is not the work of Kibera Celtic, but it's the work of the Federation, because they know sources of getting money. Because like now you can understand that the pitch, the Kisumu National Stadium is being upgraded to a certain standard. So why don't they even allocate even 2 million to upgrade Woodley Stadium?
It's really good. We inspire each other, we encourage one another, because most of us really want to play pro. I want to be professionals in this football. So most of the time we go to the games, we are prepared really well in the changing rooms, just encouragement and hoping that we win. Most of the games we've always worked together, worked as a team, and considering that we have a very good and professional coach.
I'm a coach, I love football, and that's why I'm here at Kibera Celtic, to help them. Yeah, to help them get organized and achieve, and bring some standards and try to enhance the performance of the players.
The club, which was started back in 2007, has its ambition of developing talent in the country, and through this, they want to follow the footsteps of its own ambassador, Victor Wanyama.
You know, Victor Wanyama, it has just come as a, you know, when he was going there, he never knew that Kibera Celtic is here. When he got Celtic in Scotland, so he has been questioned every and again. So did you know Kibera Celtic? So he just get to know Kibera Celtic while he's in Scotland. And now they understand the situation of the club.
And he's like an ambassador to us, because when something comes up where he is in Scotland, he always represents us as one of our own. So we are still in talks with him. We also want him to become a fully ambassador of Kibera Celtic, so that maybe we can get some help from the team back in Scotland.
But next year, we're really going for the Premier League. That is our only aim. And we really want to change African football, really, because we have talents. We have people who can play abroad. Like you see, Wanyama is one of us here. And he's really doing good job there at Celtic. So some of Wanyamas are here, and we believe so. Most of us are really good. It's only the opportunity, the exposure is not there.
Not Bernard, not John are the ones that are communicating with Celtic in Glasgow. There are some of two friends that I've told you. One is called Jamie Doran, the other one is Jim Mullins. They are the, like our ambassador, talking of Kibera Celtic is there. So yes, Victor Wanyama is there, but we don't want controversy between us and Victor Wanyama. The only thing that we can do is to follow the channel that we have been following, is to follow the two guys that have been supporting us, and from there, if Victor Wanyama is there to support us, they will contact the two guys. And from there, maybe we can get our help from there.
The best moment is that I've played with Mugabe. He's my team, he was my teammate when we were in school, even when he came to meet us. So it's a morale to me because I want to reach there.
But I'm just hoping it will go that way because really they are good talents. I don't know where they really scout the others. Because you see in the Europe and French League, all those broad leagues, they really consider most of the teenagers because they're still fresh. And most of us, we are young and talented. I'm just praying that they're going to capture that. And I think if we go to the Premier League, that is the only place SuperSport is going to capture all of us.
This is the game I chose. So I think it's a good challenge and it's also a learning process for me, yeah, as a coach. Because when we win, it is always good. When we lose, sometimes pressure, sometimes not. But with Kibera Celtic, where we started, we were in relegation. And now I think the boys have improved much a lot. So I think we are going somewhere. In the next 2 years, we have a vision. The vision for this year was not to get relegation.
Tukishinda mechi, ndio tunazidi kupata supporters wengi. Bila hiyo, hatuwezi tukaendana nao. Mon, ndio kote duniani kuko hivyo tu. Bila support kwa mashabiki hakuna mpira.
Our inspiration is our coach. He has been an inspiration to us. When we are down, he motivates us and we go strong and we win the game.
Watch us and we are coming there. We are coming to greater heights. I think it's going to be a pro club in the near future.
Kibera Celtic Football Club is in the National League. The club aspires to be among the best clubs in the country before achieving its dream of being among the best clubs in Africa. Mbaka Collins, GBS News.